Our story starts in New York, a Marvel fanfiction written on AO3 by two James Buchanan Barnes II.
Peter was just walking out of Mr. Delmar's, minding his own business and unwrapping a sandwich, when suddenly the hair on the back of his neck stood up, like it did when he was in danger. Before he could fully assess the situation, he was being slammed into from one side. He was able to stay on his feet, but barely. His sandwich, however, was not as lucky. He quickly mourned the loss of his lunch and looked up to see who ran into him. He grabbed onto their upper arm to keep himself upright.
"Hey, are you alright?"
he asked a bit belatedly, after seeing the boy he was holding onto. He was around Peter's age, with sandy blonde hair and surprisingly green eyes. He was a little cute. Alright, super cute. The boy looked at him, struggling to catch his breath. He looked surprised for a second before nodding.
Yeah, I'm good. Are you alright? Sorry about that,"
he said distractedly, while scanning the direction he came from.
"It's fine, man. Don't worry about it," Peter replied,
flustered from the whole encounter. He quickly realized he was holding onto the boy's arm and dropped it like it was on fire. The boy quickly cut him off with a muttered, "Oh shit," before running off again. With nothing but another quick look of apology thrown over his shoulder,
"Okay, bye then, I guess,"
Peter muttered half to himself, crashing to pick up his dirty sandwich and looking to see what got the boy running again. He found another boy, also their age, panting and looking around. He did a circle, and when he saw Peter looking at him, he started to approach. Peter's hair started to stand again.
"Hey, you seen another kid around here? A little douche about this tall, blonde hair?" he asked,
holding up his hand to about where the kid stood. Feeling an unwarranted need to protect the boy who ran into him, he shrugged and pointed in the opposite direction of where he ran.
That way, I think," Peter said,
before turning and dumping a squash sandwich into the garbage bin and walking in the same direction the boy had actually ran. Brushing the whole situation off and trying not to think about it, he kept heading to Stark Tower and spent the rest of his afternoon at his favorite place with his favorite people.
"You should have seen his face, Tony. It was like no one I've ever seen before. Oh my god, I wish I could have taken a picture. It was priceless. But then he started chasing me, and I had to run, Tony. I hadn't done cardio in years. Maybe I should start, like, jogging or something?"
There was a pause, and then, ha, could you imagine? "Anyway, I ran into this super cute boy walking out of the sandwich shop. I mean, like, I actually ran into him. Poor kid looked scared for his life.
Harley, look, kid. It's not like I'm not glad to see you or anything. I am. But what in the ever-living fuck are you doing in New York? Shouldn't you be in, like, Alabama or something? How did you even get here? You're, like, 12.
Peter heard his mentor's voice cutting off the other person's rambles as he was heading into the workshop.
Tennessee, actually, and I'm 17. As for the whole New York thing, can't I just visit my old favorite mechanic? Do I need a reason?
He heard Mr. Stark sigh as he finally got into the room.
"Spit it out, Keener. Why are you actually here?" "Fine. Oh, sandwich boy, what are you doing here?"
Peter's presence was finally noticed by the person Mr. Stark was talking to. It was the boy from before.
"Wait, does that mean he's... sandwich boy?"
Mrs. Quizstark questioned.
Yes, old man, keep up. This is the one who we ran into earlier, the cute one," he said as he winked at Peter.
Hey, Mr. Stark.
Yeah, we ran into each other, outside of Delmar's," he explained,
internally freaking out about the wink. Was that the second time he mentioned he thought Peter was cute?
Speaking of, I didn't bring your lunch, did I?" the boy gasped, looking extremely concerned for Peter's lack of a sub.
It's fine. I wasn't really hungry anyway."
Mr. Stark snorted, interrupting Peter's lie.
"Pete's always hungry. Why don't you take him back to his shop and get him another sub, huh, Harley?"
he suggested, nudging the boy, Harley, in the side.
No, that's not necessary. I'll be fine. Anyway, how do you guys know each other?"
Peter awkwardly asked, feeling a blush right on his cheeks.
"He crashed into my garage when I was like 11, and I saved his life," Harley explained nonchalantly, ignoring Mr. Stark's scoff. "Anyway, I'm definitely taking you to get another sandwich. Peter, was it?"
he asked, throwing an arm around Peter's shoulder and leading him back out the door into the elevator. Tony just rolled his eyes at his kids, hoping Harley didn't scare Peter too much, but somehow knowing they would all just be fine. And they were. More than that. This was the start of something new, something they all hoped would last a long, long time.